All right, well, somebody said that they'd like to see a Warmle again because I haven't done one of these in a while, and I thought, yeah, you know what? I haven't done one of these in a while. Let's try it out. So Warmle, if you're not familiar, is the game that's like Wordle, but the clues are going to tell us if this is regular Warmle. There's different versions, but this regular Warmle that we're going to start with, basically this one tells us yellow means the letter is within three alphabetically. So, for example, the C here, since it's yellow, it has to be A, B, D, E, or F. Now, it's only two the one direction because, of course, you hit A and that's the end of the alphabet. It doesn't wrap around. So if the K had been yellow, that would mean that the letter was H, I, J, L, M, or N. And then green works like normal. And that's all we need to know. So this is A, B, D, E, or F. I kind of want to do... what do I want to do? The problem is if we do like D, right, then if it's yellow, it could still be A, B, E, or F, right? It doesn't really narrow things down at all. So, but B would be the same way. B and D don't really help. So you want to do A or E potentially. I'm thinking E because, or F, E or F. Because if it's gray, then that will eliminate more things. Actually, E would eliminate the most if it was gray. But if it's yellow, it doesn't help very much because you could still have B, D, and F. So maybe F is the way to go. Because if it's yellow, you have two possibilities. If it's gray, you have two possibilities. So F is the way to go. Yep. So F. And then I don't want to do like L for this one because let's say it's yellow, right? Or gray. Yellow or gray. It's not telling us anything about I, J, or K that we don't already know, right? So it's not very helpful. So it's better to do something like O. O would be good. F, O, R. That looks pretty good. That was the, you know, three away, basically. Although Q, it's not very helpful to tell you about Q, but that's all right. How about forts? That's pretty good. R, S, and T are good letters in this game because... especially S and T, because they have several good letters kind of on either side of them. R is next to the Q, but... All right, so the F was yellow, so now it's D or E. And either one, it does... Either way, guessing D or E will give us the letter, because either it's going to be right or it's the other one. So, and this was yellow, so it's L, M, N, P, Q are probably not Q, especially since this one can't be a U. So, again, L is probably the way to go. L or... R, I suppose, would work too. Actually, it's less helpful than the other one because we do have three on each side. So yeah, L, I'm thinking L is the way to go. So let's do L there. This is Q, R, S, U, V, W. Again, I think W is going to be the good one here. And so let's do, I was going to do something like flows, but... This is, if it's a vowel, okay, so maybe we don't want to do W there. Let's think about this. Because this, if it's, we could do E-L. E. Okay, well, I wanted to do L, so it doesn't always work to do the ideal letter, but I usually start to think that way. So if it's D. If it's D, then this is almost for sure an R. D, R, and this... it could be dress with another S. That's pretty good. Hey, it was dress. All right, got it in three. Okay, now we're going to move on to Super Warmle. Now, in Super Warmle, it's the same thing, except this time the clues are only telling us two letters on either side. So you notice the yellow G here is an E, F, H, or I. So once you get the yellows, it's more helpful because it narrows down the possibilities. But when you get grays, it's not eliminating as much. So it's kind of a mixed bag there. So this, I want to do E or I probably, because if I do F and I get a yellow, then it could still be E or H. Whereas E or I, if I get a yellow, then it's only one possibility. So of course, if it's gray, then it's not ruling out as much. So I guess 6 to 1, half dozen the other. But anyways, that's my thinking. So E or I, so that's probably a vowel is what I'm thinking. We could do C here, which would check the first five letters of the alphabet. Could also do T, which would check R, S, T, U, V, which is pretty good. N is pretty good. LMNOP. So let's do C, N, or T is what I'm thinking. C, N, or T. We could do T, E. And then same kind of thing, really. T, E, N, 10. Oh, I was going to say tense. We could still do that. Let's do tense this way. That would be better. Because the reason I'm saying that is because this one, we've already ruled out the V. So the T isn't checking as many letters. Although with the S, we're checking the Q, and it's not going to be a Q anyway. So, but that's all right. Let's just go with tense. Okay. So this is now H or I. And this is Q, R, T, or U. Again, probably not Q. So I'm thinking, I don't know. We could do R, T, U. Any of them is probably fine. I like H second. But then what's going to come at the beginning? Maybe a CH? CH is good. And C is a good one to check there. It'll check the first five letters of the alphabet. CH. Now we need a vowel. Probably. Not necessarily. You could do like a CHR. But I... I was going to say IR, but... Because this is QRT or U. Yeah, we can do IR. Chirp. Chirp would work. Okay. Well, this is an I. This is an I. So the first letter, it could be E or A. I think it's more likely to be B or D. This is now Q or T, so it's a T. We're running out of things at the end here. So after a T, could do an A. You're not going to do B, L, M. You could do another T. You could do an S. U, V, W, X, Y is possible. So I'm thinking S, T, or Y are the most likely options. Probably S. And then between the I and the T, you could do I, R, T, S, or... I don't know. There's a few things, but not a lot. And could this be... Yeah, because this can't be an H. This is probably B or D. Well, could it be an A or an E? It could be. But that's a T, and this isn't necessarily an S, but there's not a lot of things that can come after a T at the end. So maybe it's a Y. Well, all right, I was thinking... I said that Y could be a letter, but then or it could be at the end there, but I forgot about that. So, dirty is possible. Ah, there we go. Okay. All right. Now, Super Warmle Plus, which again, same thing. This time, only one letter each direction, and of course, it starts us with grays, which is super unhelpful because it doesn't rule out hardly anything. All right, so which letters do we want to check the most? Like, what set of three letters are all really good, basically, right? So R, S, and T are great, but unfortunately, we've already kind of checked that on a couple spots. But S's anywhere else would be great. E, D, E, F isn't bad. So E isn't bad. B, C, D is okay. C, D, E, L, M, N. L, M, N is pretty good. So M, E, D... S, those are all really good. M, E, D, and S. You know, we could do something like messy, but the problem with that is this Y is not going to be helpful at all. It's only checking the Y and the Z. Even without those grays, it would only be checking X, Y, and Z. So that's not great. We could do something like... normally, you could do something like S's, but we've already ruled out the S here. And you've already ruled out the E here, so that's not great. Let's do bliss. It's not great. No, bless. Sorry, bless. You know, the L is checking K and M. The B isn't great, but it is doing the A and the C. You know, that's not terrible. Let's go for it. Okay, well, we got something at least. This S, so it's an R or a T. Now the downside to doing, you know, things that are three good letters is then both of the others are certainly possible. So we could do R, D, maybe R, D. That's not too bad. Let's do, this would have to be a vowel. I don't want to do A because it's only checking two letters. We could do I, of course, it's only checking Yeah, it's checking H and J, which isn't great. We could also do like TH. G, H, and I are probably better. So maybe TH is the way to go. And then we could do NTALTH, maybe? Something like filth? That's not terrible. Oh, okay. All right. All right. Okay, so again, T in the fourth spot. What could come after the T? It could be an S, but there is no S. It could be an H, but there is no H. We could do an E. We could do an E. Other than that, Y? E and Y, I think, are the most likely options. You could do an A or an O, but or a U. But I don't like those as well. They're certainly possible, but I don't like them as well. So, maybe we could do ST. ST-E? And we don't necessarily have to do the I and the T at this point. I mean, unless we think we might have the answer. But I don't know that we're quite close enough that we should expect to guess the answer on this one. So, we could do Piste. Piste, that's a ski run on a mountain, I believe. Okay, that was still good. So with the I and the T, that's and you know, normally in Wordle you would not want to necessarily repeat the greens unless you're doing hard mode because you could get more information. But on this game, doing another letter here does nothing for the other. It doesn't tell. It only tells us about that spot in the word, so it doesn't really do us any good to not repeat the greens, other than it lets you make a word potentially. Okay, so it could be ITT. It would have to be ITTY, I think. Diddy is possible. Otherwise, I'm thinking R, but then what's this going to be? Again, probably Y. But then I'm thinking dirty. Yeah, I think it's going to be T. I think it's going to be ITTY, which I think is Diddy or Kitty or Witty. Oh, no. There's three possibilities, and there's no possible way. It's not like other Wordles where you can, you know, do a word that has, you could do like vodka and check the D and the K, right? We can't check all three of those. It's impossible. Actually, wasn't... No, dirty is possible. I thought dirty wasn't possible. But wasn't that the answer to the Super Warmle was dirty? Am I misremembering that? It's probably not the same word, but Diddy would be interesting because it's basically this. I mean, it's very similar. But I was going to say, let's go with Diddy because that was my first instinct. Yeah, let's do it. Ditto. I didn't even think about Ditto. It's got to be Ditto, though. Oh, wow. Well, I'm glad I went with my first instinct and did Diddy, because although, actually, it would have probably worked out because I wouldn't have gotten the Y even if I did Kitty or Witty, and so then I probably would have figured out that it was Ditto, so I was probably okay either way. I thought I had, the 33% chance of losing there, but actually, it wasn't ending in a Y, so it worked out. But it's interesting, we had Dirty and Ditto, and I think the first one was Dress, right? Wasn't the Warmle Dress, Dirty, and Ditto? I think they were all D words. I don't know. Maybe those were words that I guessed and they weren't the answer. All right. Well, anyways, there you go. That was today's Warmle, Super Warmle, and Super Warmle Plus. So let me know how you did on these and if you thought I should have made a different guess than I did somewhere along the way, if you thought I didn't have good strategy. And of course, be sure to subscribe for more.